Good morning, Tehmina Khan is here in TK Maths is Fun. In today's video, I will explain to you a concept of variation, which is a part of the syllabus of O-level mathematics. And questions I have taken from past paper will cover inversely and directly proportional relationship, right? So before I begin, you can see on the top my website address and my blog address. My blog address has all my previously made videos, which are free and they are very much in order. You can go through and see according to your choice. And website address has checklist for exam preparation, challenging question solution, and it also offers online help if you want help in any particular topic or question or complete course. So all three types of help are available. You can register yourself. So let's begin with the question. So June 10, Variant 1-1, question 17. Question is saying y is inversely proportional to x square. And this table is given to you. There are three parts of the question. First is saying find the formula for y in terms of x. So once you will have that formula, then you can find out the value of p and q. Here p is actually the value of y when x is 2. And here q is the value of x when y is 1. So you need to recall here, first of all, when question is saying y is directly proportional to x, you write it like this. When question says y is inversely proportional to x, you write it like this. So inversely proportional means it goes into fraction, directly proportional like this. In this question, it is saying inversely proportional to x square. It means y proportionality symbol 1 divided by x square. Now you remember when you remove proportionality symbol, you write equals to k, right? This proportionality symbol is replaced by equals to k. Now k ones are k, so it will be k upon x square. Now in this table, this is the only point where x value is 3 when y is 4. So whenever you have to find out k, you need to know both x and y. So this cannot help you, this cannot help you, because there is something unknown. So you need to take help from here. You will substitute x3 and substitute y4. So it will become 3 square and this will become 4. So you will find out the value of k, right? So let's plug in the values. And you got the value of k is equals to 36. I hope it is clear. 9 fours are 36. Now, once you know this value of k, you plug in here. So this is the answer of part one. Your question was saying find y in terms of x. So now you have found y in terms of x. Second part of the question, find the value of p. So now the function y in terms of x, which you have found, you will use to find both value of p and q. So in this part, x value is 2. So you will plug in 2 here. And when you will solve, or your y is basically p. So you can write here, let me write here p, right? Because y is my p now. So it will become p is equals to 36 divided by 4, and I will get my p. So p is equals to 9. So similarly, in this part, your x is q and your y is 1. So this is what you have found in part one. So now plug in the values. In place of x, I should write here q square, right? It's easy to understand this way. So here it will become, let me erase this x, and it's better to write here q. Okay, so it will become, just give me a second. So it will become q square. And when you will take a square root on both sides, it will become plus minus 6. So this is how you find y in terms of x with the help of known values. And then using that function, you find the unknown values. Let's see this question, November 10, variant 11, question 7. Y varies inversely as the square of x. It's not different. I'm just doing because they are short questions. So I said, why not do 2-3 questions from past paper? Exactly the same thing. So when question says y is inversely proportional to square of x means this. In the previous question, he wrote x square himself. So language changes, but the meaning is same. So when you remove proportionality symbol, you write equals to k, right? So now this is given to you. So with the help of this given thing, you can find out the value of k, because now you know your y and x, and you got your k. Okay, and question is saying find y when x is 2. So you will substitute in place of x the value 2, and you will get your value of y. So you got here 9, right? Now this part, p is equals to 12 over root q. Now this question is saying describe the relationship between p and q in words. So what do you see? Is it a directly proportional or inversely proportional? Remember I told you that when we write like this, it is directly proportional. When we write like this, it is inversely proportional. So this is in the denominator. So I can say it is inversely proportional relationship, and it is p is inversely proportional to square root of q, right? Here I'm just giving you example. I'm not explaining this question, just the idea. So you can say p is inversely proportional to square root of q, and 12 is your value of k, because otherwise if it was written, it would be written like this. And when you remove proportionality symbol, you write k upon root q, like we have done in the previous two questions, right? Anyway, so this question is different. Value of k is already given to you. You have to calculate q when p is 4. So you can substitute p here, 4, right? And then simple calculation. I'm sure you are confident and comfortable with that. And then you will take what? Square on both sides, because you have to find out the value of q. So by squaring both sides, you get the value of q. So this is how you solve the question of inversely proportional, variations. So thank you very much for watching this video. If you learned something from it, you liked it, please press like and subscribe button and share it with your friends. Thank you very much. Allah Hafiz. Take care.